Hey guys, Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you a new feature in Lightroom called Guided Upright. Alright, so this new feature, Guided Upright, actually helps you take care of some of the lens distortion and barreling and kind of weird angles of things right here inside of Lightroom, where you don't have to go into Photoshop and use adaptive wide angle anymore. So let's have a look and see how this works. And what I'm going to show you today is a new tool inside of Lightroom, which is really useful for things like panoramas and photographs shot from small cameras. So this is particularly useful for drone photographers, also people using GoPro, but anyone shooting with any kind of a wide angle lens can use this to manually get rid of distortion that we used to have to go into Photoshop to do. So say for example, here's a panorama. I stitched together six images here inside of Lightroom, and I have another tutorial you can check out, shows how to do that. And what you see here is these buildings tend to be leaning over a little bit, so they're not really level. Now, to fix this in Lightroom was pretty much impossible before. We'd have to have gone to Photoshop and done it there using adaptive wide angle. But what we can do now is if we go to the develop panel here, inside the develop module, we're going to scroll down to the new transform panel. And under transform, we're going to be using upright. Now, you're probably aware upright does these automatic fixes and adjustments. But what we're going to be doing is guided. So you can either click on guided or this little tool here. And then what it does is it brings up the loop where we can actually click and drag now and define the areas that we want to be perfectly horizontal or vertical. Now, it's not going to do anything yet because I've just put one point. You have to add a second point. And then what it's going to do is it's going to distort this between the two points. So if we go over this one and release it, notice now that both of these are perfectly fixed. So it's that easy to do it. Now we can also fix horizons here. So say for example, we want this to be the horizon right there. Notice it'll just distort it around. And it's as simple as that to do this. But let's have a look at another photograph here. Let's grab just a simple photo here, single photograph, and I'm going to show you how it works on this one. So what we're going to do is we're going to go on here, grab a guided, and then we're going to take this building here. This is one of the six used in the panorama, by the way. So we've set that one. We're going to set the second one over here, and we'll let it go, and bingo, look at that. It fixes it. Now, if you want to have a little bit of perspective because it looks a little fake there, what we can do is we can actually move these points later. See that? We actually want to go the other way and see how it allows a little bit, but that's maybe a bit too much. And same thing here. Let's go this way and notice how we actually allow it to lean in a little bit. Now, some of the other adjustments we can do is you see we can change the scale and the offset. So we can actually scale it out a little bit and see the whole thing, or we can scale in if you wanted to fill up that area, or just click the constraint crop and that will also do it. But if we turn off the constraint crop, notice we can also move the offset side to side, or we can go up and down to reveal more of the photograph. So if we wanted to constrain it this way, we could go across like that and maybe just change the scale just a little bit. Just push that up slightly. There we go. So as you can see, this is an amazingly useful new feature. I hope you have a lot of fun with it. If you enjoyed this video, hit the subscribe button, add a comment, and add like. And also, I've got another tutorial that I've created on how to do a panorama from start to finish inside of Camera Raw. So check that out as well. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.